his time. We gave her a short search on this wall last time. We're going to give her a blank on this wall this time. And then we're going to extend the search all the way around a little bit further on the other wall. We have to be careful. I think she may be finding the string. So we may have to do something to change that. All right, Pat. Here we go. Very good. You can see that she's using her nose. She's checking. She got an idea that there she hit one of the last places we hit it. And she slowed down there. She knew it was there once before. Now Patty's going to sit her before we start this exercise here, because we sit before all exercises. And Patty's encouraging her. And you can see the dog is using her nose, investigating. Oh, that was perfect. That was perfect. That was perfect. She went past it and she said, whoops, here it is. And she went back. So this kind of training tends to be very subtle. It's not like obedience where you can see what the dog is doing. This is very, very subtle. Although if you look carefully, you can see the progress the dog is making. But what she's doing physically has to be read as to what she's thinking mentally. And of course her proficiency is not really great yet, nor is her training to the point where we can just ask her to go out and search without Patty encouraging her and directing her. She's kind of like a child in kindergarten. They need encouragement and they need direction. So that's it for today. We've given the dog 5 lessons, 3 sessions in each lesson. We're going to give her the day off tomorrow, and we'll pick it up next week.